Hello, everyone. Seems to me that when astrophysicists use the phrase magnetic reconnection to explain some phenomenon they see in space, they're really unnecessarily reinventing the wheel. One outstanding characteristic of our modern technological world is the use of standard modules. For example, suppose you're asked to set up the appointment schedule and billing procedure for a law firm or a doctor's office. The hard work of creating the structure of almost any computer database has already been done for you by others who are experienced in doing just that. Similarly, if you want to design and build some type of machine tool, such as a drill press or table saw, it'd be foolish to first build from scratch the electric motor that this device will use. There are many excellent quality electric motors of all sizes and speeds available to you from manufacturers that do nothing but build and sell electric motors. In other words, don't reinvent the wheel. Doing something unnecessarily from scratch when a major component or module of your design is already available to you off the shelf is foolishly counterproductive. The only reason somebody might do such a thing is if he or she were unaware of the work others have already done to produce exactly what you need. In other words, the problem is caused by ignorance. The word ignorance, as I use it here, is not inherently derogatory. It's just implying the absence of a certain knowledge. However, the reason for this lack of knowledge is usually different in each case, and this reason may indeed deserve our critical examination. It's widely believed that the wheel was invented in Mesopotamia, that's modern-day Iraq, about 7,000 years ago. There may have been an independent discovery of the wheel in China around 6,800 years ago, that's 200 years closer to us. But despite its overwhelming usefulness, many major cultures failed to discover it for the same reason. They didn't know about it. The wheel did not appear in sub-Saharan Africa, Australia, or the Americas until comparatively recent times. The reason for the reinvention in this case was that long ago, there was no communication between China and Iraq. The Chinese had no way of knowing about the original invention. In the case of the observed release of energy from a magnetic field that astrophysicists have been observing and have no real excuse for reinventing the scientific and physical explanation of this process, they can't credibly claim that nobody has studied this phenomenon. Starting in 1820, it's 1820, not 1920, 1820, with Hans Christian Ørsted's discovery that magnetic fields were caused by electrical science, the pioneer investigators into what is now called plasma physics have been discovering and quantifying and explaining this process in great detail. Hannes Alfvén was one of them. Hannes Alfvén was an electrical engineer who struggled to understand and eliminate the destructive explosions that had occurred and were occurring on high-voltage transmission lines in his native Sweden. He determined that the energy being released so calamitously was originally stored in the magnetic fields that surround the electrical currents being transmitted along these lines. Any abrupt interruption of these currents leads to the collapse of the magnetic field that surrounds the current, and that energy is usually explosively released. Alfvén said, and I quote, "In the case of the instability leading to the extinction of the current, it should be remembered that every electric circuit is explosive in the sense that if we try to disrupt the current, open the circuit, a release of the whole inductive energy at the point of disruption will occur," end quote. Alfvén extrapolated his findings about terrestrial power lines to the study of magnetized cosmic plasma. In the case of the disruption of an electric current within such a plasma, he said, again, I quote, "If the current disruption is caused by an instability in the plasma, the inductive energy in the circuit will be released in the plasma, and the disruption of a current through a plasma is often caused by a double layer of charge becoming unstable," end of quote. He wrote that in his book called Cosmic Plasma in 1981. He had already received the Nobel Prize in 1970, so he knew what he was talking about. But astrophysicists ignore Alfvén's work almost completely. They attempt to arrive at a new explanation for the release of such energy by embracing the notion that the motion and interaction of magnetic field lines is its root cause. They expound on the demonstrably false idea that magnetic fields are frozen into plasma, and by moving and breaking, these lines carry the plasma along and spew it out into space. Alfvén ridiculed this explanation by saying, and I quote, "A magnetic field line is by definition a line which is everywhere parallel to the magnetic field. If the current system changes, the shape of the magnetic field line of course changes, but it is meaningless to speak about a translational movement of magnetic field lines," unquote. So despite his warnings about this, astrophysicists persist to this day in the notion that moving and interacting magnetic field lines, independent of any electrical current causality, produce a release of energy and plasma during solar flares. They have named this process magnetic reconnection. The standard explanation of reconnection is that magnetic field lines move and eventually come together at some point. They short-circuit each other, and there they change their structure. They reconnect and move apart, carrying plasma with them. But magnetic field lines, as such, cannot move or touch each other any more than lines of longitude can separate from each other at Earth's north or south poles and carry some of our atmosphere along with them. This would be a convenient explanation for Earth's seasonally counter-rotating circular polar wind patterns. But longitudinal lines and magnetic lines are merely conceptual constructs that do not actually exist in reality. They can't grab onto something else and move it around. So a second compounding error is made by the astrophysicists assuming that plasma is attached somehow to these lines and will be bulk transported by this movement of the lines. And in coming up with this novel idea, they've reinvented the wheel. But not only is this hypothesis an unnecessary reinvention, it's based on an erroneous concept, and it has no clarifying value. Hannes Alfvén was explicit in his condemnation of the entire magnetic reconnecting concept. And again, let me quote from Alfvén. He said, "Of course, there can be no magnetic merging energy transfer. Despite this, we have witnessed at the same time an enormously voluminous formalism building up based on this obviously erroneous concept. I was naive enough to believe that magnetic reconnection would die by itself in the scientific community, and I concentrated my work on more pleasant problems. To my great surprise, the opposite has occurred. Merging seems to be increasingly powerful. Magnetospheric physics and solar wind physics today are no doubt in a chaotic state, and a major reason for this is that part of the published papers are science and part pseudoscience, perhaps even with a majority in the latter group." End quote. They've reinvented the wheel and have done a bad job of it. If we look closely at the reason for this reinvention, it becomes clear that having adamantly refused to acknowledge the effects, let alone the existence, of electric charge and electric current in space, astrophysicists had to come up with an explanation that avoided mentioning them. Moreover, in giving this explanation a catchy name, reconnection, that appears repeatedly, they can avoid restating the details of their ungainly explanation each time they use it, and thus avoid having to defend it. We hear things like, "Oh, that's just an example of reconnection," or, "Yes, another effect of the well-known reconnection process," etc., etc. All it takes to understand this argument is to recognize the clear difference between, one, on one hand, conceptual constructs that are convenient graphical tools for thinking about and visualizing a process, such as altitude contours drawn on a topographical map, and two, on the other hand, the physical process that really exists in three-dimensional space, the mountain itself. They're two very, very different things. In the law, a well-known principle is that ignorance of the law is no defense. Similarly, in science, intentional ignorance of the work of an entire academy of scholars and researchers that has applicability to the area in which you're involved is evidence of either incompetence or a lack of ethical behavior. There can be no excuse for astrophysicists ignoring the work of investigators such as Hannes Alfvén and Irving Langmuir, especially after each of them being awarded Nobel Prizes. When children who have not received adult instruction about how things really work in the real world see something that they've never seen, they often become intellectually excited. But left to their own devices, they then come up with charming and inventive but completely wrong imaginary notions about what it is that they have observed and what caused it. These explanations often involve magic. Astrophysicists are very much like children in this way. They are apparently fond of proposing entities that are invisible, immeasurable, and even unimaginable by anybody else. Our present topic is a prime example. When they first saw huge quantities of matter blow away from the sun in what we now call a coronal mass ejection, they hypothesized the existence of a previously unknown, non-existent property of magnetic fields. They named it reconnection. Even though Alfvén's exploding plasma layers had been previously discovered and published much earlier. We, the public, are being relentlessly fed scientific papers written by stubbornly insular, self-proclaimed astrophysical experts who want to impress their colleagues and funding agencies with their discoveries of new science that strictly excludes anything electrical. Their so-called artistic impressions and visualizations that they publish are not now, nor have they ever been, substitutes for real, experimentally testable, and verifiable science.